In world, nothing can be said to be certain, except death, taxes, and forms. In today's episode, we will be talking about forms, something which I don't really like, but forms are difficult to avoid. Web programming or mobile programming involves a lot of form creation. So we will start with something simple. We will do a simple form, and then in the next episodes, we will improve it. We will add a validation and make it prettier, etc. So let's go ahead and start with what we need to do. When I click this button here at the bottom to create a new message, right now I have just two buttons. So the idea is to create a form here, like a regular form for sending an email, which consists of a from field, there is a subject, and there is a body. We will add other fields later, but let's start with something simple, so just those three fields. Okay, so this screen is defined in a compose, in message compose. So here we have this column with some widgets. So let's go ahead and remove all that. So now let me add a text field. And there you go. There is a simple text field you can type into it. Nothing really happens right now. Let's create those three fields. So from, subject, and body. Okay. Now, let's start with the body. So I will increase the size of this field with a parameter called max lines, and let's set it to 5. So 5 lines. As you can see, it's now bigger. The next step would be to decorate a little bit those fields. So there is a parameter called decoration, which takes input decoration widget. And here we can define, for example, label text, which in our case will be, that's the third field, so this will be body. And there you go, you have body. When you click, the label goes up. So this attribute, you can adjust the styling, and there is a parameter called label style, which takes text style, and let's set the weight of the font to bold. Let's make it bold. Yeah, so it's slightly bolder. So now let's repeat that for other fields. So decoration, input decoration, label style, label text first, so it will be subject. And let's improve the style as well. So text style, font weight. Okay. And finally the third field. So let me just go ahead and copy that part, and this will be 2. Okay, so we have the three fields. So input decoration provides other parameters, so feel free to explore that. I will just show you a few of them. So there is a prefix icon, which takes an icon. So it adds an icon inside the text field. If you'd like to have it outside, you need to use just icon. So icon, it's outside of the text field. And prefix icon, it's inside. Yeah. So we won't be using icons here because it's not very pretty, at least in this case. Let's add a divider here. As you can see, those fields are very close to each other. They are not very well aligned. Instead of using just text field, it's a good idea to wrap text fields inside list tile. Let's try this. So I'm creating a list tile and it takes title as a parameter. And if I put a text field inside, it will align it slightly better. So let's go ahead and repeat that for other fields. Okay, so now we can remove this padding here. We can remove the whole container, in fact, so we can just use the column directly as a body. And it's slightly better. Let's improve the size of this body a bit to 8 lines. Now when I click inside, I have this yellow stripped border which says bottom overflowed by number of pixels, because this whole column is not adapted to be scrollable. And to fix that, we will wrap the whole column inside single child scroll view, which takes a child. And now when I click, this error or this problem doesn't exist anymore. We don't need this. Finally, we need the button, raised button. To send our message. Next step would be to make it work in the sense that whenever I enter some data and I click send, I can read this data from the form and do something with that. So because we are using text fields, there is a handler called onChanged, which takes a function with one parameter. And this is the value being changed. Here I added it to body, so I need to go up. Now I can no longer use a stateless widget. I must change it to a stateful widget because I want to define those fields as variables inside my widget. I need to change it. So let's create a stateful widget called message compose as before. And let's move this whole build method to here. Now I can remove this. So I need to restart. So it works. Now because it's a state class, I can define some variables. So let's say string 2, string subject, string body. And now inside the onChanged, I can just say body, which is defined in my state class, equals value. I will repeat that for the other fields. So here I will say subject And here I will say two. So now whenever I type something in those fields, the value, the current value, is being assigned to this variable. So let's check if it works. Here in the handler that is being invoked whenever I click the send button, I will try to print those values. So I'll print the to variable, the subject variable, and body variable. So whenever I press send, here in the back console I should see those values. So from Zaiste, subject, hello world, some text. Let's click send. And as you can see here at the bottom, we have those values. So this way of reading values from a form is not a proper way. We will improve that in the next episode, but for now, it's good enough. Now I can create a message. So this is something not really, it won't work that in the final version of our application, but just to show you the communication between widgets, like a simple way of passing data, I will create a message. I will use the subject and body, and I will pass this. So whenever someone clicks this button, we will use navigator and we will pop a pancake from the stack. So the first parameter is always the context, and the second parameter will be the message. Okay, so let's go back to the place where this is being invoked. So it's compose button, and here we need to change it to a message. And now we no longer have intention. So let's restart. Now, whenever I click the compose new message and I go back, I see the snack bar, because it cannot differentiate between the situation that someone clicked this button here at the top to go back to the previous screen and this button here to send the message. So here we will just do a quick fix, or rather a workaround. In IT, the workarounds are pretty popular. I would say that most of the software is just a one big workaround. So you will hear this word a lot. It's just a quick fix. And usually this is something that should be fixed eventually, but in life you usually don't have time to do this. But because we are doing this fun and we don't have any managers or deadlines, we will fix it later. So here I will just check if message is null. So this is the situation that someone clicks this button here, so we don't send any data. So this message, so this is the pop being done automatically by Flutter for us, and it's empty. The second parameter is empty, so it's null. So in this case, we won't be displaying anything. And if it's not null, so if it's a message, we will invoke, we'll display the snack bar. So let's test it. Now I click back and I don't see the message. And when I click send, I see the snack bar. So it works. And finally, so we have this message here, and I would like to add it at the bottom of those messages, but I don't have the reference to the whole list. So I need to do another workaround. So something which is not proper, but will solve our problem. So here I will change it slightly. So instead of using future, I will go back to the somehow to the previous situation. So messages, and this I will call it future. I will create another method called fetch, which will be async. And here I will assign messages, and I await message browse. In fact, no, I will do something different. So I will assign this to a future, and I will await this future here. And here I will remove this code. and I will invoke fetch here. Yeah, so that's good. And here I will pass the future I created. Let's explain what happened. Why did I do it? So now I have messages as a list and I can pass it here to compose button. So we, in the previous episode, we extracted this to another class, but we lost the connection with the messages. So now I need to pass this list as a parameter, as a property, to the widgets that are children of this widget. So in this case, compose button, child of this list widget. So I need to pass the information about the list because this compose button needs this information to update the list. So I'm passing it here. And let's create the constructor. So in compose button, we have the constructor. And here we have our, let's define this list of messages as a, as the field of this stateless, this in this case, stateless widget, and let's assign the variable. So now I have the reference to the list of the parent. Whenever I receive the message and the message is not null, I can now use this list, this reference, to add the new message at the bottom over here. So let's see if it works. My new message at the bottom. This is some random text. Okay, and let's click the send. And as you can see, the new message is added with the text that we defined. So we successfully passed this information up from the child to the parent. And the way we did it is not really it's not a proper way of doing that. We will learn later about some patterns, how to resolve the communication between widgets. But this is like a quick fix, a workaround solution that works at this stage. So that's pretty much it. In the next episode, we will tackle validations of forms. Stay tuned and see you in the next episode.